here we have a place right here on the face of the earth that is blank. That's not to say things haven't been done there before, but there are huge, vast expanses of the Southern Ocean where no measurements have ever been made, let alone the kind of sophisticated modern measurements we're capable of making now.
200 robotic floats equipped with new sensor technology are being deployed over a 6-year period to measure the biogeochemistry of the Southern Ocean. Upon reaching a depth of 2,000 meters, the floats begin their measurements as they rise to the surface, checking on temperature, pressure, oxygen, chlorophyll, particles, nitrate, salinity, and acidity of the water. That data is combined with observations from ships and satellites, with the goal of providing a continuous 3D picture of the ocean heat and carbon uptake. It's all part of the NSF-funded Southern Ocean Carbon and Climate Observations and Modeling Project, known as SOCCOM, a program also supported by NOAA and NASA.
It's like going to the doctor and they take your pulse, right? We're going to go take the pulse of the Southern Ocean, right?
Scientists try to minimize the risk of something going wrong at sea by rigorously testing the floats. Here at the Monterey Bay Aquarium Research Institute, or MABARI, it's the first day of a very tense week, dedicated to refining the new technology and checking the hardware to make sure the floats will survive in the Southern Ocean.
Going up, 5,000 PSI.
Because once the floats go in the water, and if you know something's wrong and they just disappear, you don't get them back and you don't have a chance to find out what is wrong.
Just calibrating it here and sending it out in the ocean, it's kind of like sending your daughter off to kindergarten and she's got her little lunchbox and she's gone and she's out of your hands.
The first test is in Mabari's indoor test tank, which is 10 meters deep. Every variable is known and controlled. Scientists calibrate the sensors, simulate deep ocean pressure, and receive results immediately.
So look at that first sample, that's what we're looking at. Plus 0.57, plus 0.6.
Both test floats are submerged in the 10 meter deep test tank and relay their measurements back. If the floats return numbers that don't match the known values for the tank, it's back to square one for the scientists. The result? Perfectly matching data.
That was amazing. Today we're going to go out and put them in Monterey Bay so they really go down to 1,000 meters.
To reach that depth, scientists travel 20 miles out into the bay. On this day, they deploy 2 floats. The scientists monitor and track the floats from their laboratory at Mabari, data reaching them by satellite.
And they ended up drifting all the way down to here.
After 2 days, the scientists go back and retrieve the floats.
We're gonna go find 2 little antennas that are about as big as the cardboard tube in your paper towel, 17 miles out in the ocean.
During recovery, the risk is that the boat might run over the floats and destroy the sensors.
Okay, I'm in neutral.
Data from the test deployment in Monterey Bay comes back without a single hitch. This technology will be used for all future SOCCOM floats, giving way to a new generation of oceanographic technology, one that will yield new insight into the relationship between the Southern Ocean and our changing climate.
The whole project is like the canary in the coal mine for climate change. We're putting the canary in today, and you know, in the future we'll see how that canary is doing.
Those breakthrough discoveries come from breakthroughs in technology, and that's what this represents.
It's everybody working together to really pull off a pretty unique task and trying to figure out what the role of the Southern Ocean is in climate change.
This has never been done this way before, and by the time SOCCOM is finished, we will have a much larger amount of data than the sum of all that's ever been collected before.
Data that will give scientists greater knowledge of how changes to the climate affect the Southern Ocean and how those changes will likely affect the future. I'm Greta Shum, Climate Central.